Alright, so welcome to this edition of Tentacle Cards Test Drive. Today we're going to be playing Overwatch. For those that don't know, for some reason, Overwatch is Blizzard's foray into team-based first-person shooters. Uses a visual style kind of similar to Team Fortress 2, so it's a little more bright and colorful and a little less grimdark than a lot of entries into that genre. Still has a lot of Blizzard flavor in terms of character designs and the way everything is sort of built. They've added a lot of improvements over the past several months since the game came back from its holiday hiatus into beta. There's loot boxes and hero gallery options. There's training mode, which is vastly helpful if you're trying not to be a burden to a team. There's also some additional profile options. There's ranking and leveling and stuff like that. All kinds of good things in here. Game slated for release in May, but I am in the beta, so we're gonna play a match here for y'all today. They added a bunch of play modes with the newest update. So there is a weekly brawl option that gives you sort of like a quest, similar to what Hearthstone has. Like weekly quests and WoW, a lot of stuff like that. Weeklies are familiar facets of some of Blizzard's other games. There's custom game options, so you can build a game with friends. There's competitive play option, which is currently locked for me because I have not played this very much. There's an AI bot option, and there's quick play. And I'm just going to sneeze right on video because that's happening. We're just going to jump in with quick play. It'll push you towards the tutorial. Between BlizzCons and beta and beta weekend, I've played this enough to know. It's just like a lot of Blizzard games, fundamentally very simple and straightforward. There's not a lot to be said about it. You pick a character. The character has like two or three abilities. There's an ultimate and a couple lesser abilities. It influences their movement speed and some of their like health count, stuff like that. But it's all pretty straightforward and intuitive. There's not a lot of ability bloat. It's not like picking a class entails, 50 abilities and choosing constant buttons. So we're loading into a quick match here. Depending on how many players join in, the quick match a lot of times will just kind of dump us into combat. And you'll just go from there. Okay, no one's playing a tank. I'm not particularly good with tanks, but Zarya, I play well.
Together, we are strong.
So, all these characters have cool little toolkits. They kind of fall into general roles, like tank, there's healers, there's support characters, there's builders is what they call them, which are like your sentries from Team Fortress. There's DPS type heroes.
Incoming in 30 seconds.
So on this map, we're going to be defending as a tank. If you're not somehow familiar with the role, my job is going to be to frontline the whole team. So be up there with my shield active.
Here are fools to trust the Omnix. They will see.
I got a real basic blaster. Get a cool little pulse attack. So I have a couple different options for actual offense. But then for defense, I have a shield, and I can also project shields outward. So my job here is going to be to draw fire. It's going to be to shield myself to not take a lot of damage. I kind of dislike the tank role in cooperative shooters like this because it's just kind of uncomfortable and awkward. Like, you know, if you're not good at it, it stands out. I prefer healing. I wanted to play Mercy. Mercy is like my main in this game. She's like the super best healer in the game. I might switch to her if playing Zarya does not prove, you know, good for my team.
Get in there.
See, so now I just popped the bubble up real quick on a teammate so they can
Damn.
Hold the line. There's some voice chat going on there. think I just got shot at.
Give me your best shot.
Are they going to the point?
So our goal is to defend. They have one tank, that's Reinhardt there, that just charged up at us. He's kind of a melee tank, so he has some defensive abilities that are pretty good. But, it's difficult to play Reinhardt. I like Reinhardt, like, visually. He's awesome. But I did not do well at playing him when I first had the opportunity to try. I could probably learn it. I could probably go back and do that. But Zarya, just in terms of tank role, is a much, much better fit. See, and there's Reinhardt just coming in, but he ain't getting none. Pop some shields on people. Like, if you play this as a good team, you know, you're going to do well. Much like Team Fortress 2, the emphasis is on playing as a team. It's on moving as a unit. It's on having a strong sense of
they're
vigilance.
They're on the right side.
It's on using voice chat like that, which I'm being the bad now and not saying it. But
on our right flank, by the payload.
Yeah, I see. So, like, right now, they made a concerted effort to come and take us out. So, the end result of that is that I'm going to die. I'm pinned. Nope, Reinhardt almost got me. Now he got me. Fuck. So, a good Reinhardt that actually manages to hit you with that pin attack is gonna kill you. As a tank, I mean, you have some flexibility, like, he may not do super well at killing you, but, like, he still chipped away a good amount of my health. So when you see Reinhardt coming, like, the nice thing about him as a character is that he's huge. You can see him very easily. I have no idea what my ult actually does. I gotta throw up some shield. Yeah, if we can... I don't know if this still works this way. Again, like, I have not played this very much. But I believe if we hold this point through the timer, we just kind of win. Especially in a quick match. Like, the whole point is just to go. Oh wait, there's still a porter up? No, there's not. Fuck. Okay, I think we're, yeah, the point's contested, so... Red team is trying to get it. Uh-oh. Fuck. See, that's the thing about being a tank and a shooter like this, though, is that you can get fucked up real fast. And that's what happened to me there. You get stunned, you get pinned, you're just done. Okay, so we failed to defend the payload. So now it's going to start moving. And our goal here now is to stop them from being able to escort it successfully.
Don't be shy. Hit me. Get in there.
So, there's things that you can do, like this is where having a builder hero is super strong, because what you want to have is like somebody who can put a turret up on the thing, and can kind of, you know, make the payload a moving, like, death machine. Right, and my whole goal right now is to just stay the fuck alive. Luckily the payload is covered, So it does add sort of an interesting mobile element to the match. Because what's going to happen now is I can use this real quick to kind of hide and provide cover to myself, and then I can shoot out from the other side. And the nice thing with this is that Reinhardt's shield... Uh-oh, I'm fucking stunned. This is not good. Where's my shield? Yeah, and Tracer is really hard to pin down. Tracer is like the sort of signature DPS character of the whole game. She's glass cannon, so if you can hit her, she dies pretty quick, but she has like time skip powers, and she's very fast. So, also I keep wanting to use shift to sprint, and that's my shield activation. So I keep fucking blowing my shield. Yeah, so there's like two different checkpoints. So we got our first checkpoint here, and I say we got, I mean we failed to defend against them moving it. So our goal right now is to stop it. The more of our team that gets on the checkpoint, the more that we can stop. Oh fuck. That almost went poorly. Yeah, see, I don't know what our team is doing at this point. Like, they're not really coordinating. I'm not coordinating with them, I know that, so you know. That's happening.
Give me another shot.
But yeah, like right now, because we're not playing as a unified front, the other team is playing as a unified front, and we are kind of stuck here. Granted, there is a fairly strong element of strategy to the idea of...
Come on, guys. What the hell?
Fuck. Stunned. Like, a lot of matches will actually kind of go this way, where you're going to end up just holding down at the very end of it all. But yeah, now we can reverse the payload here. And now we have a good healer going. Tactical visor activated. Best shot. Yeah, so we got, like, the hero there, the big pink mech, is sort of a DPS character who gets a mech as an ability, but you can kill the mech and then reveal the player, who's very squishy underneath all of that. So they're making a good push now. We have, like, 12 seconds now to stop it. We might actually still pull it off. It's kind of in a standstill right now. And we're in overtime, so now we have to really kind of push hard. Uh-oh. I'm fucking frozen. And we won. Cool. So you can get a kind of good sense of sort of how it works there. Farah is the one who's doing all the missile charges. Super strong in the air. They consider her a builder, if I remember correctly. because she has some abilities to kind of go stationary and do a lot of damage, mainly with like the stuff you see going on there. With the rockets and stuff, that was like super not explanatory. I'm probably gonna switch to a healer, especially if the dude continues playing Reinhardt. Healer again, that's more where I'm like strong. So got leveled up. Now I get a loot box. There's elements of this game. So this game is a purchase and play game. It's not free to play. Having said that, Blizzard is notorious and good at building addictive ass hooks into games. So stuff like loot crates and or loot boxes, because loot crate was probably a trademark, and leveling up and those mechanics are basically intended to keep you playing this game as long as possible. So I'm gonna go into this as Mercy. Oh, we lost our top deeps. Damn it. We don't have any tank heroes either. We don't have any other supports though, so I think by picking Mercy, I'm gonna be in good shape. And someone else will pick a tank. You don't really need, like, the team tips that they give you, you don't have to follow the composition. It helps, generally, if you do that. But you don't have to. You don't have to have a tank. You don't have to have a healer. These things do make elements of the matches easier. But they're not strictly essential. So as a support, as Mercy specifically, I get a couple of different support abilities. Mercy is probably the closest parallel to the old school Team Fortress 2 medic. You get a healing beam, which is super straightforward. You also get a crit beam. So that's a right click on your standard weapon here, and that increases the damage done by the player you're targeting. You can also switch to the super fun healer gun. Mercy also has the ability to fly to allies, so you see the little lock-on reticle when I mouse over a player. If I left shift, I just kind of fly to them. Intention there being that I heal people. And by healing people, I also get healing myself, so it's pretty valuable. And since we don't have a tank, I'm going to kind of use the opportunity to support this sniper, and I just died. Yeah, my positional awareness is shit, and I know it, but here you go. This is also kind of a cool little map. A lot of these maps are set off of real-world locales, but they're in this sort of weird, like, mecha future or whatever the fuck that Blizzard put together for this. Patching you up. So, it's like, hey, look, this is Nepal, but there's, like, robots and shit? Maybe? It's weird, right?
Did someone call a doctor?
Ooh, Reinhardt. All right. This one is a sort of like a King of the Hill, for lack of a better term. We have to contest the point, and I just fucking ate it. So our goal here is going to be to capture the points and make sure that we get a really good grasp on the map.
Back in the fight.
That being said, we're not doing a good job of that now.
Let's get you back out there.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you're in glory.
Yeah, see, the one thing that sucks about Mercy is that traditional healer, traditional glass cannon problems. You will jump in and you will get fucking owned. You can kill a lot with her. Like, it's actually kind of surprising. Oh, fuck, I had my ultimate. The other good thing about Mercy as a healer is that she's the easiest to learn, despite her glass cannon status. And her ultimate is a mass res. So if you saw that I had the little counter telling me how many teammates were dead, the reason that is because when my ultimate's charged, I can just hit Q and bring them all back. If I play like a non-noob. Fuck.
Best round
lost.
Well, that happened. Yeah, that sure happened. Alright, let's see what our team comp is.
What?
We have a tank. Okay, good, we're good. Yeah, for stuff like this where you're going to attack as a group, you really do want to have a tank more often than not, and a healer, because this setup is very essential. I'm going to try playing a different support, though. I am going to go to Lucio.
I am ready to roll. Healing boost!
Oh, fuck. Yeah, some maps have traps like that, where you can just fall down and die. Yeah, and then he hopes no one saw that, because of course.
Locked by the dragon. Scatter.
Go. I feel sad this morning. Go.
Yeah, see, I have no idea what I'm doing with Lucio. I am gonna switch to Zenyatta.
I've got you in my sights.
Enemy turret ahead.
True self is without form.
Cause that's a little bit better. Yeah, like his stuff is way
enemy turret
easier
destroyed.
To understand.
Hold up.
He's got a cool little theme, he's got cool attacks. You get some healing from being near your healing ally. So I've got my little healing sphere on him. I can just pop it right on to another player. So I only get to have one at a time, but it does a good amount of healing, and it heals me too. So, yeah. Oh, fuck. I just got rocked.
GG.
Yeah, we just lost that match.
It's her move.
Adversity is an opportunity for change.
I mean, at this point, yeah, it's pretty... It's pretty definitively locked in. Yeah, there it is. We lost. But you get a good sense of the game here. We'll take a look at some of the other options. So, I'll show you the loot box and stuff like that, because these new features are kind of the cool stuff they're adding in that's going to make the game really awesome. It's going to stand out quite a bit. Well, stand out quite a bit's debatable, but it's going to... I think it'll be a little bit better for it. But you get cool shit like this. Like, play of the game gives you a good, solid indicator of what's going on with other players. I'm just going to commend the one person on our team that did anything worthy of note, and I'm leaving. So, like, Hero Gallery, this is kind of cool. You can go in, you can take a look. It has skins. You can kind of rotate around. You got emotes. A lot of these are locked. I'm not sure how you unlock these, to be honest. Not sure. You can go to Hero Info. You can see the abilities. It gives you a full explanation and a cool little, like, video. A lot of these, they just play on the video walls at BlizzCon when you're waiting in line to play the game. But, you know, they're cool. But you can kind of see... Okay, so it's if you have stuff open, because there's emote packs and stuff. That's right. Okay. So, like, they have a classic skin. You can go in, you can look at that. She has a chrysanthemum, which is a different color. Heliotrope, different color. Jade, also a different color. So you can just see the different colors of the skins. But there are some that are drastically different, like Firefighter, Rescue, Abominable, which looks pretty fun, actually. That's kind of cool. And Yeti Hunter. Also pretty awesome. So you can go back. But yeah, you can see a lot of cool stuff for a lot of the characters. Skins and stuff will be the way you kind of differentiate. Well, duh, that goes without saying. I'm just being dumb. But there's some pretty cool stuff in here. Like, a lot of these skins are awesome and very different. Like Punk Tracer, which this is actually my first time seeing that. That's pretty awesome. I want that. Oh, that's even better. And then there's, Mock Tracer, a little throwback to the original, to the story, origin story of Tracer. Actually, Slipstream is more that, because this is like Pilot Tracer, which is cool. But you can see some of the cool stuff they have in here for these characters. Some of these skins are just custom locks, like Noir Widowmaker is a pre-order bonus that you can go get. That's badass. Okay. So a lot of these are pretty cool. Some of these pay homage to other Blizzard games. Not as much as like Heroes of the Storm, where there's a lot of stuff like that. Where characters kind of cross over. But you get good color variations. A lot of the characters have really awesome, cool, just interesting visuals. You know, they're all kind of built differently, which is nice. So like, here's big badass Reinhardt, who you can color out all you want. Oh, and all of a sudden, look, it's a dude. Just pretty cool. Oh, that's my favorite right now. That Paragon armor, yeah. I'm all about that. Oh, never mind. Fucking Nightmare from Soul Calibur just showed up, hello. I did not know they added this kind of stuff in. I'm even more... Oh, okay. There's a cool little, like, paladin crossover armor. I want to see that on a WoW paladin now, actually. Holy shit. Ooh. Let's see. What else do they have in here? That's another character we kind of played with a little bit. Zenyatta. We got cool color themes. Interesting that you have a lot of skin choices given that you can't see your own character, but nonetheless. Ooh, that looks nice. It's pretty crisp. Oh, snap. That's good. That's even better. I got really hyped for this all of a sudden again. But anyways, we will leave off there, so make sure to tune in next time.